Of course, Western Pennsylvania is home to so many proud sports moments over the years. From Bill Mazeroski's game-winning World Series home run to Franco Harris's immaculate reception.
But this is special. As special. Channel 4 Action News anchor Mike Clark has the incredible story of uncommon integrity. It is a story you have never heard until right now. Mike.
Wendy and Andrew, this is a story of a man who might be the greatest, most courageous hometown athlete of all time. This is the legend of Charlie Pruner West. A lightning quick track star at Washington High School, Charlie West was so fast, he once took on a horse in a race.
And he beat the horse?
Yeah. His sister said that the local kids, one kid was riding a horse, and Charlie was running on the side of it, and he beat them.
His name etched in silver. Whippeal and national track records, trophies still on display in the halls of Wash High. The name Charlie Pruner West, engraved in the brick Prexy Hall of Honor at the football stadium for his powerful running and tackling abilities on the gridiron. Charlie's brilliance in the classroom opened the door to admission at Washington and Jefferson College, becoming the only black member of their football team. Charlie endured physical and racial threats and slurs from opponents and fans, leading WNJ to college football's biggest stage, January 2nd, 1922.
This story has to do with that particular game in which we were led by the first black quarterback ever to play in Rose Bowl history, Charlie West.
25 years before Jackie Robinson broke baseball's color barrier, Charlie West and his 10 white teammates never came off the field, playing offense and defense and special teams to a sold-out crowd in Pasadena. Charlie also led the defense, holding the mighty California Bears to a Rose Bowl record low 56 yards rushing. Cal did not complete a pass, nor did they cross the 50-yard line. The game ended in a 0-0 tie, but Pruner West was on the fast track toward greatness.
It's the American dream. Charlie West grew up a few blocks from campus in a little house, still there. And, you know, through education, higher education, through the ability to play athletics and learn leadership skills, through the options that he got here that allowed him to go on to medical school, he changed the lives of his family and his community. That's the American dream.
This is that little house, still standing on the corner of North Lincoln and Spruce, where Charlie West began fulfilling those dreams. But in the 1923 season, an ugly incident involving a home game against Washington and Lee, a Southern school, almost ended everything. Washington and Lee demanded Charlie sit out their game because the team did not play against blacks, a courtesy usually extended to Southern schools, until now.
Well, Washington and Jefferson said, "We're not benching Charlie West." And Washington and Lee said, "Well, we think you'll feel differently about it. We're coming up anyway."
Charlie told his coach, John Heisman, if he sat out, he'd never play again for W&J. All of the players voted to support Charlie, saying they'd forfeit instead of playing without their teammate.
I think probably they saw him as a person and not as a black person.
On game day, the Southerners, as they arrived at the Washington train station, told W&J, "If you don't play, you'll have to pay us thousands of dollars as the contract dictates."
And they said, "Well, we acknowledge the contract, but we're not benching Charlie." And they went down to the bank, took out the guaranteed minimum, paid Washington and Lee, and sent the team home, shouting, "Shame, shame, shame."
W&J took a stand for equality.
The W&J was the first school to actually say, "No, we're not going to, you know, basically conform to everyone else's ways of thinking back then. Like, we're not going to sell out one of our players, you know, just because he happens to be black. We're not looking at him like that. We're looking at him, you know, as the fact that not only is he a great player, he's a great individual as well."
The uncommon integrity here: Charlie West sprained his ankle that week in practice and could not have played.
And I just think it was awesome that, you know, come to find out later that he probably wasn't going to play anyway because he had a messed up ankle. So, I mean, it definitely showed that, you know, they weren't going to just stand there and let Washington Lee just, like, make demands.
I'm sure that the support of his team was important to him. It had to be. But I'm sure he also had individual strength that is really remarkable and incredible courage.
He didn't personally think that he was anything special, but he really was.
Allie Gilmore researched Charlie West's remarkable life from his humble beginnings. his two national pentathlon championships in college, making the 1924 Olympic team, and walking away from a professional football contract for medical school, and his 50-year career as a physician in the Washington, D.C. area.
Talk about an uplifting story.
Wow.
DeAndre Simmons, a student athlete, football player like Charlie West, said, look, I didn't play in the Rose Bowl. I'm not going to become a doctor. But Charlie West really lives on campus. He's going to inspire him to go full steam, he said, and achieve his dreams. You know, uncommon integrity. Go to WTAE.com right now for my full interview with President Tory Herring Smith, detailing the legend of Charlie West.
What a great story.
One of the hidden chapters in the entire civil rights movement.
Right here in Western Pennsylvania.
Nice job.
Thank you, Mike.